This is Good Morning Indiana, working for you.
Time right now is 4:27 here on our Tuesday morning. We want to thank you for starting your day with us here on Good Morning Indiana. I'm Lauren Casey.
And I'm Meredith Barrick. We begin with the violence that plagued our downtown over the weekend. And the president of the Fraternal Order of Police wants to know why community members aren't more upset about the violence that occurred down there. If you recall, six people were shot.
Yeah, and this involved juveniles, so young people as well. And police believe this had to do with a dispute. And basically they're saying, where's the outrage for this? Are we growing numb to this type of violence? Because we've had so many shootings, so much violence here in Indianapolis, really this past year. So we're going to be looking at what the community is doing, what police are doing, and who they're looking for, because they still need the public's help this morning.
Community members on the east side, however, are being recognized for their hard work to overcome crime and neglect in their neighborhood. This is an area that we frequently see all sorts of violence occurring.
Yeah, plagued with violence there in this far east side neighborhood. So in contrast to what's been happening downtown, we're gonna look at how this neighborhood has been working to turn things around and why they're being awarded for their efforts. Our own Alyssa Donovan is gonna be breaking down that story for us this morning, and maybe other neighborhoods and communities want to kind of replicate what they're doing over here. Right now, we do want to take a turn right now, bring in our own Todd Clausen and talk about the forecast for today. Todd, I got outside for a walk yesterday evening. Beautiful day. Yeah. That humidity dropping always makes it feel really nice.
Yeah, huh? You know, we told you that was going to happen as soon as that front went through, and it set us up for what it's going to be the best weather day of the week today. You're really going to enjoy the forecast. If you walk outside this morning, some of you may want the light jacket. Definitely kind of have that fall-like feel out there with some temperatures that are now in the 40s. We're at 48 in Zionsville, 50 in Bloomington, running a little bit warmer here in the city at 57 as expected. In Logansport, sitting at 50 degrees. The skies are completely clear. We'll keep an eye on the potential for maybe a little bit of patchy fog to develop across the area, but otherwise look for mostly sunny skies today. That low humidity continues and a high temperature that eventually gets up to right around 79 degrees.
I did have my heat on in the car this morning.
Oh, no, you did not.
Mm-hmm. I had my seat heaters on, but I always kind of do. It feels good.
not for the entire drive, but yeah. It started off that way.
Todd doesn't do that until much later. Maybe have the windows down. Maybe have the windows down. All right, Todd. Well, another story we are following for you today is part of our Hiring Hoosiers Classroom to Career series. Our Aaron Lish is looking at the benefits to a dual degree education. It's all about getting the most bang out of your buck, saving you time and money. So she's heading over to IUPUI, where they're putting this practice in place, to see how this is benefiting students and getting them ready for the real world and the workforce. We'll have that story plus your news, weather, and traffic updates coming up right here in Good Morning Indiana.
This is Good Morning Indiana, working for you.
Coming up on Good Morning Indiana, one person is dead after being hit by a vehicle on the east side. The very latest from police on that investigation.
And a surprise announcement from the Marion County prosecutor why Terry Corey is stepping down.
And a former informant is accusing the Muncie Police Department of excessive force. Details on this federal lawsuit now filed against the city. Time right now is 4:30 here. It's a Tuesday morning. Thanks for starting your day with us. I'm Lauren Casey.
And I'm Meredith Barrick. And Todd Clausen forgot to wear his red dress this morning.
Yeah, where's your red dress,
Todd?
This was merely coincidental.
I was not about to wear a red dress, but I could have worn a red tie at least.
We should have texted you.
This was merely coincidental. So sorry if you feel left out this morning.
I'll get by just fine here throughout the day.
Yes, and we will get by fine with the weather.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a beautiful day for us. The best weather day of the week. We're starting off on the cool side with temperatures that are in the 50s across the area. 58 right now in Muncie, 57 in Indianapolis. Bloomington, you're down to 50. You'll probably drop into the 40s here this morning and up to the north. 50s in Anderson at 51 degrees, right at 50 in Logansport. So it's the coolest morning we will have this entire week. Going forward, temperatures will be a little bit warmer, but one of the reasons why we're so cool is the clear skies that we have out there all across the area. And as we expand out, you know, some high thin clouds back off to our west. But that is just about it. Otherwise, we are going to enjoy a beautiful day here from start to finish. We'll warm quickly. You'll notice that here throughout the morning hours. We'll jump from the mid-50s to about the low to mid-70s already by the noon hour. And then as we work our way into the latter half of the afternoon, we'll see our high temperature eventually get up to right around 79 degrees. The time now is 4:31. Let's get a first look at traffic on this Tuesday morning.
All right, Todd, thanks so much. Let's take a live look right now down on the south side, I-65 and I-465. Traffic in this area is moving along just fine this morning. You can see the barrels, they're off the travel lane, so that is great news for your commute. Let's take a turn right now, head over to the west side, I-465 and West 46th Street. Traffic here is open, moving along up to speed. No major crashes or delays here on the west side to slow you down.
A woman is dead after being hit by a vehicle on the city's east side. The crash happened around 9 last night in the 1100 block of North Rural Street. Police believe the woman was in the street when she was hit by a driver. She was pronounced dead at the scene. If you have any information about this crash, you are asked to call Crime Stoppers.
Well, a Marion man reported missing 2 weeks ago has been found dead. According to the Grant County Sheriff's Department, 64-year-old Henry Schneider's body was found near a wooded area in eastern Grant County yesterday. A silver alert was issued for him on September 15th. Police have not released any additional details at this time.
Marion County Prosecutor Terry Curry announced he is stepping down to focus on his health. Curry made the surprise announcement yesterday, saying he's battling advanced prostate cancer.
And so at this point, I'll rely upon my family, my faith, my friends, and the world-class medical treatment at the IU Simon Cancer Center to address my health going forward. And with all that going for me, I am completely upbeat about where life leads from here.
Curry was joined by his family and members of his office during the emotional announcement. He mentioned his office's work pushing for a state hate crime bill and sensible gun regulation for Indiana. Now, Curry's time in office included two of the most notorious criminal cases in the state, the convictions of three people behind the deadly 2012 Southside explosion and the 2013 conviction of former IMPD officer David Bessard, who was intoxicated when he hit and killed a motorcyclist. Curry took over as prosecutor in 2010 and was reelected in 2014 and 2018. Before that, he was deputy prosecutor for 6 years. Chief Trial Deputy Ryan Mears will serve as interim prosecutor. Since Curry is a Democrat, the Marion County Democratic Party will have 30 days to select his replacement. That person will serve as prosecutor through the end of 2022. Curry is going to stay with the prosecutor's office as deputy prosecutor with the grand jury.
At 4:34, the city of Muncie is facing a lawsuit after a former informant claims that he was the victim of excessive force by the police. 35-year-old Danny Terry filed the lawsuit in federal court last month. It says that he assisted Muncie police in September of 2017 in the investigation of a Muncie officer suspected of trafficking controlled substances. While at the target's home, Terry says officers ordered him to lie face down and then stomped on the back of his head. He suffered a serious brain infection because of the injury, and now he has brain damage. Terry is a convicted drug dealer and is currently serving a 16-year prison sentence. He alleges that the city was negligent, used excessive force, and violated his constitutional rights. Attorneys representing the city of Muncie released a statement saying, quote, "The city of Muncie disputes Mr. Terry's allegations and his credibility. He resisted the reasonable commands of law enforcement, and we are confident the facts and evidence will support such a determination," end quote. The federal authorities are reportedly investigating the Muncie Police Department for police brutality.
For the second time this month, Indiana Governor Eric Holcomb is on an international trip to drum up business benefiting Hoosiers. He and a group of business leaders arrived in China yesterday. They'll spend several days there and then move on to India. While there, Holcomb will also get to watch the Pacers play the Sacramento Kings in the first ever NBA game held there.
At 4:35, hundreds of General Motors workers from two Indiana plants will picket together as that nationwide strike continues into day 9. Employees from the Kokomo and Marion plant will meet in Marion to show solidarity in the union's push for higher wages and better benefits. Other GM workers in Fort Wayne are also on strike. Some say they are finding strength in the union workers' solidarity.
I don't know as far as money-wise, like how long I could last or go on, but I'm still gonna fight and I'll still be out here.
The UAW says they've made some progress with negotiations, but the deal has not been reached. The workers will receive a strike pay of $250 a week should they hit the 15-day mark. But for many workers, it's a drastic cut from their weekly pay.
A nonprofit academy that teaches Hoosiers how to code has been growing since we first told you about it last year. 1150 Academy's original location is in Fishers, but they have now moved their headquarters to a location in downtown Indy. Yesterday, they held a ribbon-cutting ceremony for the official move to Ohio Street. The Academy already has a cybersecurity classroom there. The idea is to be in a more central area so more Hoosiers can take advantage of their coding programs.
We are able to pull students through the program in 12 weeks to 24 weeks, and our graduation rate is over 90%, with a placement rate that's over 80% into jobs that are paying 70, 80, even more $1,000 in starting salaries.
The U.S. Department of Labor designated 1150 Academy Indiana's first registered apprenticeship program. That means all graduates working with 1150's employer partners will get guaranteed jobs.
President Trump is now being accused of holding aid to Ukraine before a controversial call with their president. Coming up, Trump's reaction as questions over the whistleblower reports continue.
And the FDA is recalling more blood pressure medications. Still ahead, why they're being pulled from pharmacy shelves.
It's a beautiful morning here across central Indiana, a little on the cooler side. Skies are clear and temperatures are currently sitting in the 50s in most locations, but a couple of you are in the 40s. Despite the chilly morning, it's going to turn into a beautiful day. We'll talk all about it in your Storm Team 6 forecast. The time now is 4:38. You're watching Good Morning Indiana right here on RTV6.
Cares like family.
Welcome back to Good Morning Indiana. This is a live look from our NDOT traffic camera at I-65 and I-865, where traffic is moving just fine this morning. We'll continue to keep a close eye out for any construction or crashes that might slow you down, and we will keep you updated.
Here are the stories making national headlines today. A hearing will be held with the House Oversight Committee to address the outbreak of lung illnesses linked to vaping. The amount of teenagers using e-cigarettes continues to rise, and now more than 500 people have been diagnosed with the illnesses. At least 9 deaths have been reported nationwide.
President Trump will take the stage at the United Nations General Assembly. President Trump says Iran will be one of the topics he will address in his speech. Looming conflicts over trade war with China and nuclear negotiations with North Korea may also be addressed.
Questions for the president also continue to mount over whether he pressured the Ukrainian president to investigate Joe Biden in exchange for foreign aid. Here's ABC's Inez de Lucatera with the latest.
As President Trump gears up to address the United Nations General Assembly today, he's still pushing back on that Wall Street Journal report.
It's just a Democrat witch hunt. Here we go again.
Insisting he did nothing wrong by repeatedly asking Ukrainian President Zelensky to investigate his campaign rival Joe Biden. At the time of that call, the Trump administration was withholding $250 million in aid to Ukraine that Congress had already approved. Now the Washington Post reports Trump ordered staffers to freeze that aid just days before his conversation with Zelensky. Trump denies there was any quid pro quo.
I did not make a statement that you have to do this or I'm not going to give you aid. I wouldn't do that.
But minutes later,
I put no pressure on them whatsoever. I could have. I think it would probably, possibly have been okay if I did. But I didn't. I didn't put any pressure on them whatsoever.
Back in Washington, Republicans have been mostly silent on the matter.
We don't know enough about it.
But a steady trickle of House Democrats are now lining up to support impeachment. Even House Speaker Nancy Pelosi hinting at it, threatening a whole new stage of investigation if the Trump administration doesn't hand over the whistleblower's complaint to Congress by Thursday.
He may force us to go down this road, and we may very well have crossed the Rubicon here.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi will hold a closed-door meeting with members of her caucus this afternoon amid reports that she's been quietly discussing with her allies whether it's time to impeach. Inez de la Quintera, ABC News, Washington.
Here at 4:43, flights are being canceled to bring refugees to the United States. A fiscal year 2020 moratorium is in place, but it's unclear why it's being enforced or when it could be lifted. Last year, President Trump set the refugee cap to 30,000, which is the lowest level since 1980. The administration is nearing that ceiling with more than 28,000 admitted as of last month.
The Federal Drug Administration is expanding a recall on blood pressure medication. Two medications from Torrent Pharmaceuticals were found to potentially pose a cancer risk. The voluntary recall includes Losartan potassium tablets and Losartan potassium hydrocolloidalkyl tablets. Check online for that correct wording there. This is related to a larger recall that has been expanded since July.
Here at 444, multiple people have been rescued as parts of Arizona are underwater from monsoon rains. Crews had to rescue five people, including a mother and a child, from their vehicle. This morning, central Arizona is still under a flash flood watch. The storm is expected to bring at least an inch of rain, along with hail and strong winds. And back here, Todd, we finally got a little bit of rainfall yesterday, early in the morning hours. What's it looking like out there, though, for us?
Yeah, you know, we needed that rainfall yesterday, and we got quite a bit of it, at least compared to where we've been all throughout the month. Now, up to 0.4 inch of rain, but we're still nearly 2 inches below where we should be for the entire month. So yesterday was beneficial, no doubt about that. We needed it. We got it out during the morning hours, turned into a beautiful day. There's the chance of some more rain entering our forecast as we head into the day tomorrow. As far as visibility, Lafayette was just down to 0.25 mile. Notice it's up to now 0.75 mile, but that's some pretty good fog there in Tippecanoe County, probably in some of the lower points there right along the Wabash River. But again, the rest of central Indiana is in pretty decent shape. As far as visibility goes here this morning, here's the view from downtown. Looking off towards the north, and skies are clear, and with the clear skies and the light winds overnight and the low humidity, our temperatures have dropped off very, very quickly. Where the winds are out of the west at 3 miles per hour, there's that dew point all the way down into the low 50s. The air is a very dry, and temperatures this morning are in the 50s in most locations, but some of you are now dipping down into the 40s. 48 in Crawfordsville, this little pocket of blue here in between Tipton and Indianapolis, that's with temperatures in the 40s as well. As you work your way down into the Zionsville area, 50s the current temperature rate now in Bloomington as well as Greensburg, and I would expect some locations here to see our temperatures fall back down into the 40s, at least a little more widespread as we go forward throughout the course of the morning hours. So you may want a light jacket as you walk out the door. Otherwise, skies are clear all across the area. You notice some high thin clouds off to our west. They will bypass us to the north. You don't have to worry about that whatsoever. And there's no threat of any rain in the forecast throughout the day today. So one thing that will happen is the temperatures will warm really, really quickly here throughout the course of the morning hours. 59 at 9 a.m., 70 already by 11 a.m., and then we're into the low to mid 70s as we work our way into the course of the afternoon hours, about 75 by 2 p.m., and then temperatures will eventually top off anywhere from about 77 to 79 degrees for our high temperature. It's just a spectacular day from start to finish. Take advantage of it if you can and get outside and maybe get a walk or a bike ride in at some point. Just keep in mind, though, sunset now gets a little bit earlier, 7:39 right now is sunset, and temperatures will be in the 60s once we get throughout the evening hours. Then overnight tonight, we're going back down into the 50s and 60s, probably right around 60 in the city, 50s in the outlying areas. Not quite as cool tomorrow morning as this morning, but nonetheless very, very pleasant. Here's your forecast for tomorrow. The clouds will increase throughout the day. Temperatures into the mid-70s, and there will be the chance tomorrow of a few showers entering the forecast as we work our way into the afternoon hours. Nothing to write home about, but just don't be surprised if a few of you see a passing shower throughout the day tomorrow. Thursday is still seasonable at 76, but then the heat builds in as we work our way into the weekend. Highs back into the low to mid 80s.
All right, Todd, thanks so much. Here's a live look right now as you're heading into downtown I-70 at West Street. Everything on the interstates in this area is traveling up to speed, but we do have a reminder about ramp work that's going on this week. It went into effect yesterday, and it's going to last through Friday. Let's take a look at our map. This is happening in the area just before the south split. The ramps to eastbound, westbound I-70 from Meridian Street and also in the opposite direction. That whole ramp system is closed as NDOT is working on some winter repairs. You'll need to use West Street or Harding Street exits as detours throughout the week, and we'll keep you updated on that project. Right now, we are just monitoring some slowdowns on southbound I-69 through Fishers as well, so give yourself just a few extra minutes. Let's take a live look right now from our NDOT traffic camera on the south side, I-65 and I-465. You can see traffic here is moving along up to speed in all directions. No issues to slow you down.
Apple says it's keeping production of its top computer here in the U.S. The tech giant announced it will continue to manufacture manufacture its new Mac Pro in Austin, Texas. Apple has been making the Mac Pro in Texas since 2013. Reports claim that the company was looking to move production to China due to the trade war, as they need parts from China to make the computer. The Trump administration granted Apple an exemption from those tariffs over the weekend.
Well, researchers have discovered a hidden continent on Earth buried under southern Europe. They found it while reconstructing the evolution of the Mediterranean region, which stretches from Spain to Iran. The new continent is being called Greater Adria. It's about the size of Greenland, and researchers say that it broke off from North Africa and buried under southern Europe about 140 million years ago. They say many tourists have probably visited this without even knowing it.
IHOP is releasing new spooky menu items for Halloween. After the break, a look at the Addams Family inspired dishes.
And after a violent weekend here downtown, police are addressing that violence. New at 5, what they think needs to change to make Indianapolis a safer place. But first,
I'm Vinny Politan. Coming up today on Court TV, we are live in Dallas, Texas for the very high profile case of Texas versus Amber Geiger. She's a former police officer who was coming home from work, went into her neighbor's apartment and shot and killed him. She says it was a tragic mistake, but prosecutors say it was murder. Today, we should hear the 911 call. Today, live on Court TV.
Don't forget, you can watch the all-new Court TV live on your mobile device by visiting CourtTV.com. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Good Morning Indiana. Time right now is 4:54 here on your Tuesday. And we're keeping a close eye on your morning drive. This is I-465 and I-69 there on the northeast side of town. It looks like traffic is picking up, but it is traveling up to speed. No crashes or issues here to slow you down.
A fire department in California is celebrating the birth of 9 newborn babies with an adorable photo shoot. Take a look. The firefighters with Rancho Cucamonga Fire Department had the babies photographed with their firefighter gear and in other locations around the station. They posted these photos to Facebook saying, "We are thrilled to see our RCFD fire family keep on growing." Very sweet.
Yeah, very cute there. Well, they're creepy and they're kooky, and now they're the new inspiration for the new IHOP menu item in honor of the Halloween season and the new Addams Family movie. The restaurant chain had added 4 new breakfast items named after characters. There are Wednesday's web cakes, which are pancakes topped with chocolate syrup, white icing, and violet whipped cream. You can also get Gomez's green chili omelet, Uncle Fester's chocolate ice cream shake, and Morticia's haunted hot chocolate. The items are now available for a limited time through November 3rd.
I could go for that.
I could go for a stack of pancakes right now, I tell you. That looks pretty good. All right, we do want to bring in Todd right now and talk about what you can expect as you're heading out maybe for breakfast or to start your work day.
Yeah, you might want to grab that extra cup of coffee, not to wake you up, but to warm you up just a little bit. Temperatures here this morning have dipped down into the 40s in some locations. Everybody else is in the 50s, but it turns into a beautiful day for us with lots of sunshine, high temperature of 79 degrees. Some showers will build in throughout the day tomorrow. Nothing to really write home about, but a couple of them will linger into Thursday morning as well. And Thursday we're at 76 degrees, but then we're back up into the 80s. Another warm weekend ahead with Sunday potentially getting close to 90 degrees in some locations. Overnight lows come up as well, but all in all, not a bad 7-day planning forecast. We'll talk more about it in detail coming up when Good Morning Indiana continues. The time now is 4:56. Stay with us. We'll be back in just a few minutes.